Let me call my big bro Cameron Baker real quick, see what he up to. Yo, what's good, bro?
Man, I'm chilling, you know me, but you getting ready for your big game tonight against your hometown team, right?
Yeah, man, you already know. This is an important game for us tonight. We need to win this one. But I'm heading up to the United Center right now, but I need to ask you one question, though.
Oh, man. Yeah, what question, man?
I seen the game when you dropped 94 points against the Knicks live, and I want to know how were you able to keep scoring like that without getting tired at all?
I don't know, man. I was just in a good mood. I was focused, and I was just dropping buckets, dog. And before I knew, I had like 90-plus points. So just go out there, play hard, and focus on dropping buckets, little bro.
All right. Bet. Appreciate that, man. I'm almost there, so I'm going to hit you up after this game.
All right, Jay.
All right, bro.
Badickens.
Bro, you know you forgot to hang up, right?
Badickens.
Wow. What the fuck was that?
Hey, y'all hear that? Y'all hear that? This crowd is buzzing right now. Tonight, those cats won't even be able to hear themselves think. Let's do it.
Yo, what's going on, YouTube? It is your boy, Sean. Shout outs to my nigga, Stacks Montana, for... You know what I'm saying, being in my intro and stuff like that, but bringing y'all another My Career video. And you see I cross up Jason Kidd, got his ankles all beat up, but Jason Kidd comes back and blocks my shot. And now they on a fast break, Melo dish it off to JR Switch, and he pulling up and he's switching it from three. They don't call him JR Switch for nothing. Sixth man of the year, he putting in work. As Tyson Chandler is guarding me, but he switch off me as Melo come on, and I'm bumping him, getting my way to the paint and getting an easy layup for 2 points. And they coming down the court, Kidd looking for somebody, he dish it off to JR, pulling up for three, and he's swishing it from three again. JR is nothing to play with as they setting up a play for JR, and look at that alley oop. To be completely honest with y'all, I don't even know why I tried to block that. You can't block dunks in this game for some reason, but look at that crossover pulling up for three, and that's cash bet. What a splash. The New York Knicks are trailing by 1 point. Luol Deng has the ball. Coach want to clear out for me. I break this man ankle twice, getting a dunk on Melo. Instagram that dunk. Come on, Melo. You should have had a flashback on when you dunked on Paul Millsap. You should have known to get out my way. The Knicks are now trailing by 3 points after being down by one, but they dish it off to Melo. He pulls up for the three, and he tied up the game 11-11. And now Derrick Rose is coming up the court. I can see it in his eyes. He's about to take this to the hole as he get past Amari, going up with a one-hand dunk. All I know is that Derrick Rose better calm his ass down before he get another injury. We need him this damn season. As I'm calling for a screen from Boozer, dishing it off to Boozer, he hit the hot step over Amari, and I'm getting my first dime in tonight's game. And you already know I'm calling for that quick isolation, hitting a couple dribble moves, stepping back, pull up for three, and that's another bucket from downtown. That's what? 3 3-pointers already, and look at that man ankles being broke over nothing. I dish it off to my man Nate Robinson, and I get my second assist slash dime in tonight's game. And now we are trailing by 2 points. It's 34-32 as I'm called for the reaching foul, and now my coach is sitting me on the bench until the first half is done. So I will see y'all in the second half, and make sure y'all check the description if y'all want to skip the halftime show.
I do. Oh shit. Act like you don't God. Finally famous, nigga.
Best drinks, good tree, and bad bitches. Yeah,
I got the best drinks, good tree, and bad bitches.
Yeah,
I got the best drinks, good tree, and bad bitches.
God.
And that's what you gon' get anytime you fucking with us. Finally famous, what's up?
What's up?
Yeah,
it's finally famous over everything.
What's up?
Yeah,
that's over you too.
Good,
little hoes.
Whoa.
D-Town,
yeah.
I'm on the west side of my city.
Swerve.
Riding around like a tour guide with a white girl. She got a tongue ring, man, that might as well be a bullseye. She half naked, walk around this bitch.
Whoa.
Almost thought I was poolside, trying raw dog my...
Oh.
Like a tube top, but that's suicide. One time for my niggas who made something out of nothing. Cause you could lose it all, my nigga. Look at David Ruffin, yup.
And we are back from the halftime show. Now in the third quarter, we are trailing by 6 points and creeping up to the three-point line. I got the man with that ankle breaker stepping back, pulling up a three, and that's nothing but net. I took the advice that my boy Cameron Baker gave me. He told me to just stay focused, and that's what I've been doing. And my three-point shot been on all game as I get the right-hand layup over Marcus Camby on the New York Knicks. And now Marcus Camby is being posted down from Carlos Boozer, and he missed. Jason Kidd get the rebound. They dish it up to Melo. They pass it off to Shumpert. Shumpert is taking flight and dunking all over me. I don't know why I even tried to contest that, knowing you can't block dunks in this game. And this lead the Knicks got is getting way out of hand as I'm stepping back, stepping behind the three-point line, pulling up for the three-point, and I missed the shot, but I'm getting my own rebound. I'm looking for that three to cut the lead short as I pull up for the three, and that's wet like water. Right now is comeback time. We need this win, and I'm about to do anything I can to bring my team back as I step back, pull up for three once again, and that's another three-pointer from downtown. I cross over Melo this time, pulling up for three once again, and that's another three-pointer from behind the three-point line. I'm being double-teamed, and I don't want to pass it, and it wind up getting slapped down, and that's a turnover. So I run to the right, run to the left, stop, pull up for three once again, and that's buckets from downtown. And we are now trailing by 2 points after being down from 11 points to 5 points. We finally cut the lead down to two as Joakim Noah gets the defensive rebound. We really needed that rebound from Noah. I'm calling for the ball. I'm red hot. D Rose does not pass it to me. He passes it to Carlos Boozer instead, and he turns the ball over. I am red hot right now. They don't call me red hot for nothing. I'm red hot. Three after three after three. You don't pass it to me when I call for the ball. Now we turn the ball over because of Carlos Boozer, and J.R. Smith is wasting hella time. He gets past me, go up with a hot step, and he gets the 2 points, and now we are down by 4 points, 83-87. Carlos Boozer got the ball. I'm calling for it, calling the quick isolation, crossing that man over, pulling up for three, and I missed the damn three-pointer. I was red hot until Carlos Boozer turned the ball over, and that is game. He spoiled the comeback, and we lost because of that. I'll see you on the post-game interview.
Having just been named the Rookie of the Month, can you tell us how that feels?
It's a huge honor for me to win this award. I have to give a lot of credit to my teammates, our great fans, and the coaching staff for believing in me and giving me a chance to show what I'm capable of.